First of all, yesterday it was a record-breaking 106 degrees in Seattle, Washington. Strange times. Speaking of heat though, let's talk fire movement. Today I wanted to share something I thought was really cool that I first learned about last week that's related to FIRE. Typically the FIRE acronym stands for Financial Independence, Retire Early. And there's a whole movement about people saving and investing 50% or more of their income in an effort to reach financial freedom as soon as possible. However, I heard a different acronym of FIRE last week that was unique and possibly inspiring for some of you today. And I liked it because I thought it was much more prescriptive than the standard acronym. Because Financial Independence, Retire Early describes the end result. It doesn't explain at all how to get there for new beginners. So I was listening to Paula Pant's Afford Anything podcast, and she had the guys on from the Choose FI podcast. The whole episode is great, and you should definitely give it a listen. I'll link to it in the description down below. It gets pretty deep and philosophical about the entire changing landscape of personal finance, investing, jobs in general, the economy, and even the future of higher education. But there was one short part in particular that caught my ear. Paula shared her framework of FIRE at the 50-ish minute mark, and I'll actually just play a quick part of this for you now, since I think she obviously says it best.
The way that I think of it, the framework that I like to use is FIRE, F, financial basics. I nailed that down first. And then once the F was taken care of, IRE, investing, real estate, entrepreneurship. So the IRE of FIRE, that all got built on top of those financial basics.
Did you just add an option to the FIRE definition a la carte menu?
I sure did. That's how I think of FIRE, financial basics, investing, real estate, entrepreneurship. Take care of the F first and then pivot to focusing on the IRE of FIRE.
But let's dig into this a tiny bit more and pull this apart for some takeaways. So Paula says that F stands for financial basics. Start there. Pay off the credit cards, save up an emergency fund, establish good credit, get to net worth positive. She calls this financial solvency, which means having more assets than liabilities. Even just knowing the difference between assets and liabilities is key here. Now, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention I wrote an entire book about mastering financial basics, specifically 101 finance tips, and this book is called The Money Resolution. Check this out on Amazon if you're interested in that. So that's F. But in terms of the IRE in FIRE, Paula believes this is the most important part. I stands for investing. It's critical you learn and master investing and develop your own strategy and philosophy around it. It's extremely important you start as soon as possible so that you can maximize your compound interest growth opportunity. So for me, that strategy is dollar cost averaging and automation. It's investing in low fee index funds that track the entire stock market or the S&P 500. And it's prioritizing maxing out all of my available tax advantage retirement accounts before any individual investing. And if you want to know what I use, I actually prefer M1 Finance to do all this, especially for a Roth IRA and traditional IRA. I also use it for my rollover 401ks from the past and totally recommend it for automation and no fee trading. I'll drop my referral link in the description down below if you're curious about getting started with M1 Finance. You actually can get $30 for signing up. We both do, which is pretty sweet. Investing can certainly sound scary though at first, and I totally get it. It was for me. But scary doesn't mean hard. Like with most things, once you start, it's not as difficult as it sounds. The hardest step is the first step, but keep it simple in the beginning and commit to learning. Future you will thank you. In Paula's version of FIRE, R stands for real estate. Now, truth be told, Paula actually built up $43,000 a year in net rental income by age 34 from 8 rental properties. I think she actually became a millionaire before age 30, but this is not the norm, and I actually hesitate to tell you all this because it can actually be discouraging, especially if you're not as young as that and still a renter like me. Comparison is the root of unhappiness, so there's no need for that. Instead, I encourage you to strongly consider real estate ownership as part of your future plans if that's not you yet. It doesn't have to be 8 rental properties or even 3. Real estate can be your own home and only that. I actually haven't talked about it on the channel, but my fiance and I did spend the last 4 months seriously looking to buy our first house. We lost out on multiple offers we placed by a lot, but a year ago, before learning about home ownership, I was starting to convince myself that we should rent forever, that that was the best financial decision, but I have come around and I think that would be a big mistake. We may not buy in the next few months or even year, but after my learning and research, I do think it's wise to buy. We'll be patient for the right one though, and you should too. Measure twice, cut once when it comes to real estate. Don't rush in due to peer pressure, but learn real estate and consider it for you and possibly for rental property. It might be your ticket to financial independence like it was for Paula Pant. Let me know, do you agree? Do you own your own home or rental properties? I'd love to hear about it. The E in IRE stands for entrepreneurship. She really didn't talk much about this on the episode, and I couldn't find a lot in research on her thoughts, but it shouldn't be too hard to speculate what she meant by this based on what I know about her. Now, it doesn't necessarily mean start and run your own business from scratch or come up with something amazing now. It could simply mean diversifying your own income. Side hustle, learn about passive income, start a small brand or business online and commit to it for the long term, even if it doesn't make you money at first. I actually tell friends and family when they ask that it will take 2 years or more to make money on YouTube, even if you're consistent and make one video a week. And I truly do believe that. But making money from something you work this hard to build over time is even more satisfying than a desk job paycheck. Plus, it's extra security. So learn about and create your own LLC. Learn about tax breaks and benefits. Do something that helps people and solves a problem as your number one goal, and you will find success. Remember, in the long run, cream always rises to the top. Aim to be great at whatever you choose to do, but diversify your income and help others in the process. You won't regret it. So, in Paula's version of FIRE, the F is financial basics, but it's the IRE part of FIRE that really matters. In her words, IRE gives you multiple exit points as an exit from your day-to-day 9-to-5 if you do IRE right. It's the IRE of FIRE that leads to true financial independence. If and when you add Paula's version of IRE to the F, financial basics, you'll surely discover financial freedom. It's not easy to master investing, real estate, and entrepreneurship, but if you hadn't considered one or some of those, I do think it would be wise to consider those endeavors in your financial journey. I think it's always fun to hear a fresh perspective and new views about different definitions of FIRE and different financial independence paths. In fact, I recently covered 10 different versions of FIRE in this recent video that I think you should check out next. I think you'll really dig it. So that's the meat of what I wanted to share today that I heard and loved, but I also wanted to share her definition of financial independence overall because I thought it was super wise. So I morphed a few of Paula Pant's definitions of financial independence into this clear explanation. Financial independence is the state in which your passive income, typically through investments, gives you enough of a safety net that you can live fearlessly. It's when you can make decisions from a place of hope and desire rather than fear or obligation. When most people hear typically through investments, they think traditional investing. But investing can also be investing in real estate, whether it's your own home or rental properties, and investing in a business or creating passive income. Paula's twist on the FIRE acronym is a reminder that financial independence has many definitions and early retirement has many paths, like I covered recently in that video. To each their own when it comes to financial success, but I hope you are encouraged to keep going. Keep pushing. Stay motivated no matter where you are in your financial journey. Enjoy the ride and don't get overwhelmed. But always be learning and be sure to subscribe here if you'd like some more motivation and talking FI twice a week with me here on YouTube. My favorite thing about YouTube is the comment section, so let me know what you think of Paula's framework and acronym. Beyond financial basics, what stage of IRE are you currently working on or want to work on? Do you have your own acronym or version of FIRE you'd like to share? If so, please do. Also subscribe to the Afford Anything podcast. And Paula, if you watch this, thanks for all you do. And I would be honored if you'd consider writing the foreword to my new book I'm working on, encouraging people to save and invest half so they can retire twice as fast. Let's connect, but either way, you rock. For the rest of you, like this if you like this. My name is Frankie. Your name is phenomenal for getting to the end. I'll see you, I hope, in a few days on the next one. Thanks. Check out one of these two FIRE videos next. And stay cool out there this summer. See you guys.